For the past three seasons, no one has dominated America's most grueling off-road motorcycle racing series like this man. Three-time and defending Grand National Cross Country Champion Caleb Russell has his work cut out for himself this season as a star-studded field has their sights set on this season's number one plate. The opening round of the 2016 GNCC is next.
For 75 years, Daytona Beach has served as the focal point in the annual trek to kick off riding season with Bike Week. For the off-road racing community, the action is 60 miles to the north of the World Center of Racing. It's the Moose Racing Wild Boar from Palatka, Florida, opening round of the AMSOIL Grand National Cross Country Series presented by Maxxis and AMA National Championship. I'm Jason Wygant to give you the call here on NBCSN. When you come to Florida, lots of things to be afraid of, but perhaps no creature strikes fear in the heart of racers like three-time and defending champion Caleb Russell coming back from injury.
It's been challenging to come back from, you know, ACL reconstruction, and we've been just as soon as I was able to start doing stuff, I really haven't stopped training, you know, since I've gotten into it. So, you know, 3 weeks after the surgery, that's when the recovery process started, and it's been going good. I feel really good, and I got a trainer, and been on a really good schedule, and feeling really good about everything, you know, off the bike. And I started riding a lot sooner than any doctor would, you know, advise me to. But you got to start sooner or later.
And here's why Caleb wants to get to work. Only five seasons so far in the Premier class. He's already third all time in the GNCC wins list, besides legends Scott Summers and Rodney Smith. But here are some of the riders trying to stop him from winning races and titles this year, starting with Grant Baylor, runner-up in last year's series, and he was only a rookie.
This year I'm just going to try to start out a little quicker and hopefully get my first win under my belt this year, and use everything I learned last year for this year, and hopefully have a lot stronger year this year.
There's so much hype going on for the first round, so I think we'll get through today and just ride my own race and try and get through just clean and finish, have a good race and get a good result, and it'll be nice to get a win today though.
Years past, I was ready to go out and get top fives, but nothing less than a top three today. You know, I've been working too hard not to be on the podium, and you know, it's what sponsors want, so I got to give them what they want. So, I feel fully prepared. I feel better than I ever have coming into the first round, so let's do it.
And here's what Bad Thad Duval and the rest of the boys are going to do. Your format, 3 hours of racing on an 11.5-mile track, probably get 6 or 7 laps in. We have two pro classes we will cover today, XC1 for the 450s and the smaller 250cc machines. We've got on board here with Grant Baylor on the NFAB Am Yamaha, and the season is underway. And Russell, a good start, leading them into the first turn. Oh, and he tangles! That's Ryan Sipes, who nearly gets run over, or did get run over, by Baylor. Rest of the field, a mad dash into the woods. There's Sipes on the right. He's up and going, but you've got to fear for Russell, who had the knee injury coming into this season, and he finally gets the engine lit, and you hope that knee is okay. That is a nightmare scenario for his team, FMF KTM. There's Daniel Milner, number 31, second, but your all balls hole shot award and your lead. Ricky Russell on the Suzuki coming all the way out of the Pacific Northwest to race here in Florida and making good on it. Sipes got a lot of ground to make up on the Coastal Racing Rockstar Husqvarna, and so does Russell, 17th and 18th. However, it's a three-hour race, so plenty of time to make up ground. And Russell's been down in the first turn a lot at this Florida opener. Seems like an annual deal, and he's made up ground before. Let's go back and look at it again. Trying to tell if Russell got hit by Sipes or not. I don't think so. I believe he just broke the back end loose. And by the way, that's the 7 of Jordan Ashburn going down with them. Here's what it looked like again from the helmet cam of Grant Baylor. Russell sideways, hit by Sipes, runs into Ashburn, and that's one of those classic deals. Sipes is going to say that's on Russell. Russell's going to say that's on everybody else. We go back to XC2. These are the young guns of GNCC Racing on the 250s. Battle into turn one. Hotcam's hole shot award on the line, and it's going to go to the 11. That's Craig DeLong on the Coastal Racing MSR Husqvarna. New team this year. And Craig's brother Andrew, meanwhile, is up front in that XC1 class. So the DeLong boys, at least good starts today. And you love watching this class because a lot of young talent. And a mix, by the way, of 250 two-strokes and four-strokes. DeLong, you see the big pipe. And you hear the revs. He's on the two-stroke. Making it look good. And this class is so big. These are all the ambitious young shorts who want to make a name for themselves in this division and then move up to a big ride in the XC1 Pro Division. And speaking of XC1, Russell continues to lead it. Ricky Russell. And how about this in second place? They call him the Sandman, the local threat, Garrett Edmiston, who's always strong at this race, filling in for the injured Jerry Robin, who's a former amateur motocross sensation, now switching to the woods. So a big shakeup here with Russell in the lead and Edmiston in second, and all the big championship favorites are nowhere to be seen. Whoa! Russell almost pitches it away. Edmiston, though, he's always a dark horse threat in the sand. He's very fast in these conditions. That's what he grew up on. Battle here for third. That's Jason Thomas in the number 8. He is last year's XC2 champ, making the move back up the XC1 division. And the field's still pretty tight. You can see that Caleb Russell coming through now still has a view of the pack in front of him. He's trying to stay in touch with the leaders. Here's Thomas working his own deal on a Yamaha this year. And Josh Strang on the 114. Rockstar Husqvarna. There's Andrew DeLong behind him. Stuart Baylor. Oh, and down. Baylor gets tagged to the back by Chris Bach on the number 4 JCR Honda. Caleb Russell around them. Baylor, Sipes. So Russell and Sipes are already back in the hunt. Stuart Baylor, he's just getting sand kicked in his face today.
When it comes to guarding your engine, AMSOIL offers the next level performance enthusiast demand. AMSOIL provides 75% more engine protection against horsepower loss and wear than required by a leading industry standard, extending the life of pistons and cams. Give the vehicle you love the above and beyond protection it deserves. AMSOIL, devoted to protection.
Here at Rocky Mountain ATV MC, our goal has always been to get you the best price and provide quality service. Now, we're giving you one more reason to shop with Rocky Mountain. We call it Quick Cash. It's simple to get. Just place an order with a qualifying Quick Cash item and get cash to spend on your next order. Try it out today. RockyMountainATVMC.com. Get ready.
Maxxis Tires.
The Andersons discovered life is easier with an Outlaw RV. The Outlaw is a complete home on wheels with a multifunctional garage. Getting on the road has never been quicker. The Outlaw is made to fit the lifestyle of today's active families. So stop roughing it and start enjoying your weekends. Find the Thor Motor Coach Outlaw that fits your needs at GarageRVs.com today.
The GNCC series on the NBC Sports Network is brought to you by AMSOIL. Protect your weekend. Rocky Mountain ATVMC, get ready. And by Maxxis Tires, keeps you riding to your maximum potential.
Well, there's a class for everyone in Grand National Cross Country Racing. There's Zach Davidson out of North Carolina taking the youth bike overall on Sunday morning. And the day before we raced the bikes, ATVs. There's Chris Borich on the left, Walker Fowler on the right. That's the old and new champion of the series. Should be a great showdown between those two this year. On board with Adam McGill, who looks to have a start but is just squeezed out by the one of Fowler. And Walker proving that number one plate not going to weigh him down this year. He starts the title defense in the best way possible with a dominant win. And shout out to the young gun, Bryson Neal, getting quicker, faster, stronger every year. Fifth in the series last year, runner-up today in Florida. And back to our bike race here this afternoon. What is this? Some mid-race trash talk. That's Caleb Russell and Thad Duvall So apparently things have boiled over between those two. That's Daniel Milner in the Yamaha pit. Now Russell on the number one. Remember, he was involved in this incident earlier. Just joining us. There it is, a hard first turn crash. So he's already mad. Then apparently he and Duval have done something to rub each other the wrong way while trying to fight through traffic. Ricky Russell on the yellow 212 continues to lead, but look at the charge being put in by the 903. That's Tyler Medaglia, a motocrosser from Canada, who comes down here for some winter training runs and always is fast at this race. Riders trying to figure out the best way through the mud and water. Big part of the GNCC game. A wide line for Edmonston in blue, and he's going to get past. I think that's Andrew DeLong getting him. This should be Josh Strang rolling through. He's got Chris Bach right next to him. And here comes Caleb Russell right through the middle of the water, trying to make up ground for that first turn crash. And Jordan Ashburn coming right through with him as they both try to make up ground from that big wreck early. We're going to flash back here to XC2. These are the young kids in the 250s again. Tegan Temple into the lead and on the beta. So we get to call him the Alpha Beta right now as he leads that 250 class. Here's Ricky Russell continuing to hold the lead, but he's got, oh, and down in the mud now goes the Canadian Medaglia. So now he has some mud racing experience he can bring back to the Canadian Nationals this summer. There is Andrew DeLong, who's third, and our camera crew just struggling to figure out which way are these guys going to go. These are the swamps of Florida. It's what off-road racing down here in the Sunshine State is all about. And how about this pack? I'm talking 10 riders with a shot at it. This is great racing. And I don't think out of all this competition, anyone thought, yeah, it's going to be Ricky Russell and Tyler Medaglia leading everyone around. There's Chris Douglas on the Suzuki keeping in touch with this pack. There's Russell all the way on the left. Now cutting straight through the middle, and the champ almost drowned out. Shakes his head. Not the start to the race. Your three-time defending champ won it, and he's got Grant Baylor right behind him. So 1 and 2 in the series last year are pretty much last and next to last of the lead pack. Medaglia going back after Ricky Russell for the lead through the mud and the sand and the rough terrain, and now into the woods. Oh, this is a great way to start this AMSOIL Grand National Cross Country season. And forget about this little gap you see back here as Milner comes through, followed by DeLong. That gap's going to go away. These guys are going to tighten up as the day goes on. Tegan Temple tips it over while leading. Tegan Temple tips. And taking the lead is Lane Michael out of West Virginia. That new Coastal Racing Husqvarna team making it look good right now. They got a whole shot with DeLong. They've got the lead with Michael. Here's DeLong still in third. And Barry Hawk, your 8-time GNCC champ, is team manager for that outfit. They also have Ryan Sipes up in this XC1 class. Now Andrew DeLong has finally secured the lead. He has definitely fought hard to get it. Great story. DeLong was injured at this race last year, and that really started his 2015 season in the wrong direction. Never really recovered, so he needs a comeback here. Medaglia second, Russell hanging on to third, and here comes the cavalry. I told you these guys would close up. Strang, Milner, Edmonston, Bach, and Sipes. Caleb Russell nowhere to be seen. Same thing with Thad Duval, who we had the early run-in with. And well, no questions being asked for Andrew DeLong on the 410, who's checking out on the Husqvarna. Medaglia comes through next. You got to watch out for Strang. He's been closing and closing. Now up to third around Ricky Russell. And Strang has the most experience out of everyone in this group. 2010 GNCC champ. Won 3 of the last 4 races a season ago. Strang's going to be tough to hold back as he's into that third place position. Hey, there's Thad Duval, the number 5, just getting through. Jordan Ashburn of the Westfield Power Sports KTM. And this is Russell. I mean, we're not even talking top 10 for your defending series champ right now.
At Rocky Mountain ATVMC, we want to help increase rider participation at your next race, rally, or club event with our free Race Gas program. Join Race Gas, and every rider that signs up for your event or club gets a free $10 gift card to Rocky Mountain ATVMC. It's that simple. RockyMountainATVMC.com. Get ready.
When it comes to protecting your engine, AMSOIL offers the next level performance truck owners demand. Amsoil provides 75% more engine protection against horsepower loss and wear than required by a leading industry standard, extending the life of pistons and cams. Give the vehicle you love the above and beyond fortification it deserves. Amsoil, devoted to protection.
CST Tires.
Welcome back. It's the opening round of the Amsoil Grand National Cross Country Series, and this is what it's really all about. We have riders of all different classes, amateurs and pros, struggling on a very rough racetrack. Off-road racing, especially in these three-hour affairs, is as much about survival as it is about going fast. Yes, you cannot finish first unless you can first finish. Josh Strang and Chris Bach have now hooked up in a battle to be first. It's a bit upside down from where we were earlier in the day. Andrew DeLong and Tyler Medaglia push back to third and fourth while Strang in this tight terrain trying to get away in the Rockstar Husqvarna. Bach and the Johnny Campbell Racing Honda right there. And these two Husky riders not giving up. Medaglia and DeLong hanging with them. You can see the pace has really picked up. Strang is always good here at the sand tracks, although the Australian says he doesn't have much experience on them.
No sand where I'm from. There's a couple of tin mines that were done like in the 1800s or something that I used to do some sand riding as a kid, but not much. So it's different down here. It's real fine sand, so it'll be good. It'll be a tough day, but looking forward to it.
Well, if it's tough, Strang really excels in those conditions. He is a fitness fanatic. There's a lot of cycling and mountain biking with some very elite athletes in the North Carolina area where he is now making his racing home in the U.S. And Chris Bach spends a lot of time in North Carolina as well, and this guy is out of Indiana, and he's very fast in these sand races. It makes even less sense than Strang, who says he doesn't have much experience. Bach has virtually none, and he's always good at this event. Medaglia holding strong in third. And here's Sykes. Now Sykes, goes down nice the front, and this is what takes your energy. 3 hours of riding hard enough, but when you got to pick the motorcycle up a couple times a day, well, that really takes it out of you. Watch this left-hand turn. Just turns the front wheel a little too sharp. That's what they call knifing it. And my guess is there was a line or a rut that he wanted that he probably just missed, and that's what led to that problem with the front tire. Tough break for Sipes, the converted motocross and supercross rider. Hey, Chris Bach taking the lead over from Strang. Like we said, he's always strong at this event.
Yeah, I think to improve over my podium finish last year, it's really just about preparation coming into the race. Last year was a really good event for me. I do well in the sand typically. I like it. It suits my riding style. Being a bigger guy, I can use my legs to the advantage. And this year, I feel more prepared than I did last year. I put in the work in the off season, and the test is today. We'll find out if it pays off or not.
And Strang right back there. He and Bach going back and forth. And Strang got to the preferred line of the inside. Bach had to back it down and loses a little bit of ground in a hurry. And now closing it back up. So these two, now that they've hooked up together, they have pushed the pace and they have pulled well clear of the rest of the field. Remember, it wasn't that long ago. We had 8 or 10 riders in the same picture. Hey, Trevor Bollinger here. That's the teammate of Bach, racing in the XC2 class on the Honda. Johnny Campbell Racing, switching from the deserts of Baja to the woods here in the east. So far, so good.
As riders and racers, we understand the need to get quality parts, apparel, and accessories fast. We have the horsepower of multiple warehouses to make sure your gear, OEM parts, or accessories make it to your door quickly. Check out our easy-to-use website and experience customer service that takes the whole shot. RockyMountainATVMC.com. Get ready.
You smell it, you feel it, you can taste it in the air. Speed, man.
Full wide open. Blast.
I didn't really like high school too much. Too booky, too take notes, learn this, and that's it. Got a wild check.
That full-size motorcycle.
The feeling of taking them apart every day, putting them back together.
Woo!
Can't explain it. Everything I learned applies to now. Seeing your motorcycle that you put together ride around the track at 180 miles an hour. Oh, definitely rewarding. My name's Mike. My school's Wyotech.
Get on the fast track to a career. Turn pro at Wyotech.
When it comes to guarding your engine, AMSOIL offers the next level performance enthusiast demand. AMSOIL provides 75% more engine protection against horsepower loss and wear than required by a leading industry standard, extending the life of pistons and cams. Give the vehicle you love the above and beyond protection it deserves. AMSOIL, devoted to protection. Maxxis Tires.
The GNCC series on the NBC Sports Network is brought to you by AMSOIL. Protect your weekend. Rocky Mountain ATVMC, get ready. And by Maxxis Tires. Keeps you riding to your maximum potential.
And just saw the highlights of our women's cross-country race from this morning. Casey Martinez on the factory KTM taking the victory there. Congrats out to Casey. This man, Josh Strang, trying to win the overall in our afternoon pro race. Josh Strang on the Rockstar Husqvarna out of Australia, beginning to distance himself. Had a great battle going with Chris Bock for a while. Bock still second, Daniel Milner third. Strang, man, he is so fit. And you see how rough this track has gotten now. That fit is paying off. Ryan Sykes fourth. And there's his buddy Caleb Russell. These two down in a heap together in turn one. So Russell has finally moved in the top 10 and now top five. And this could be interesting. Strang is kind of secure right now in the lead, but Bock, everyone else closing in on him a bit. We could have a big battle for those last two podium spots. If you're Strang, this is what you wanted. A little bit under the radar, I feel, coming into the season. Sipes won the overall win at the prestigious International 6 Days Enduro last year, and he has the big name for motocross and supercross, so a lot of talk about him. A lot of talk about Grant Baylor, second in the points last year. Strang a little under the radar, but he is so capable of doing exactly what he's doing right now on the 114. That's putting his head down, getting to business, and pulling away from the best off-road riders in the world. He's got this thing in control right now. But how about Milner? Now that is actually Strang's roommate. The two Australians live together in North Carolina. Milner, in his first year in the U.S. last year, struggled big time. Rider down in front of him, he avoids that. Milner has type 1 diabetes, and if you think it's hard to handle 3 hours of racing like this, another rider stuck, you think it's hard to handle 3 hours fitness and endurance in these races normally. Diabetes, it's going to be tough. And Milner has put in a lot of homework during the offseason to figure out his diet and training. He's going to need it because Sipes and Russell are beginning to close the gap. So it'll be interesting to see if Milner can hang on. Last year, he just did not have the endurance past the two-hour mark. But here comes Sipes and here comes Russell. They're in a battle, and I guarantee you this pace is going to help them close in on Bock and Milner. Sipes going to ride the wide bike here. He doesn't want Russell to get around him. Russell blasts through the water. Well, that's one way to do it. So he's going to move up one spot to fourth. We go back to our leader, Strang. He's looking so good on that machine. Grant Baylor just behind that battle we saw with Sipes and Russell. That is sixth place in the NFAB and Pro Yamaha through the one of the multiple muddy water crossings here. Strang still has it locked down up front. Russell, after making the move on Strang, has gotten away from him, making a late bid for the podium. He's got to try to get Milner and or Bock. Now, Sipes losing a little ground late, and I talked to Sipes before the race. He admitted it. His home in Kentucky, it snowed so much in the offseason, he didn't get to ride as much as he wanted to. He was afraid that might affect him down the stretch of this race. That's Bock and now Milner, second and third. We'll just keep the camera here to give you an idea of the gap. Back to Russell, who was way outside the top 10 early. Here he is. He's definitely closing the gap. It was actually Milner and Russell who had the fastest times on the next to last lap of this race. So third and fourth on a roll. This is Bach in second. Yeah, they're saying push. It's his buddy Johnny Gallagher races the ATV side. They do a lot of training together. And he wants his buddy to hold on a second. Here's Russell going to stop. No, I thought his wife Chandler was going to give him a drink of water. The champ doesn't have time to stop. He's digging deep. And now Milner in third has caught Bach. So a maybe three-rider battle soon for second in this race. Yes, it is a three-rider battle. Russell is there as well. Milner around the outside and takes the spot away from Chris Bach. And this is such a good sign for Daniel Milner to have this kind of fitness down the stretch after all the struggles he had physically 1 year ago. But no one has an answer for Josh Strang today. What a performance. Didn't have the start. Methodically worked his way forward, outdueled Chris Bach for the lead, and never looked back. Josh Strang wins the opener, the Wild Boar GNCC. And we're going to go down to the wire here for second, third, fourth. Hold on to it. Here comes Russell. He's going to try to make a move on Milner. And he does. Now Milner able to come back. And Bach is right there as well. All three going to the finish line together. Milner, Russell, Bach, what a finish. 3 hours of racing and it came down to the last turn and Milner will emerge in second. His first ever GNCC podium. Oh, that has got to feel good. And he celebrates it alongside Josh Strang. These two rode and trained together the entire offseason. And all that work pays off. They go 1-2 as you look at the Rocky Mountain ATV MC results. Bollinger's ninth place, good enough for the win in XC2. Here's the rest of the top 20. And now the Maxxis Tires post-race interview with Josh Strang.
I didn't spend any time in Florida, so I've just been riding in the clay. So I was a little bit worried about this race here, but I've been working hard. So I think fitness here today really paid off, and I'm excited to go to the clay tracks here in the next few weeks.
All right, congrats to Strang. Here's your Amsoil race recap. Big crash early, Caleb Russell, Ryan Sipes, Jordan Ashburn down. They would all have to work their way from the back. Meanwhile, Strang would come from about mid-pack to get the lead, but he had a battle on his hands. Chris Bach, Andrew DeLong, Tyler Medaglia, all right there. And Bach and Strang really pushed it. They got aggressive midway through this one, pulled away from everyone else. Once Strang secured the lead, that battle was over. Bach was trying to hang on. Daniel Milner passes him on the last lap, and Milner has Caleb Russell with him in a fight for the podium. As Strang takes the checkers, everyone wondering, what's the rest of the podium going to look like? Milner, Russell, Bach, a bang, bang, bang finish after 3 hours. Milner, a hard-earned second.
The bike couldn't be any better, especially for how rough it is out there. It was just going in a straight line. It felt real good. So, I mean, got to give it up to the AmFab, AmPro, Yamaha team, and you know everyone that's supporting us. It was a fun race. I enjoyed it out there.
Enjoyable for him, not so much for others. We'll be looking for revenge all season long, and we'll have the full tour right here at NBCSN. For everyone at Racer TV, I'm Jason Wygant. Congratulations to Josh Strang.